What's up, guys? It's Tyler Prime. Yes, it's still the same day as today. I upload 3 videos at a time and sometimes I don't. This time it's an actual scary video, so welcome to Scary October. I always feel like I should add like those you know those ghosts go, ooh, I always feel like I should add that at the end. But next year, I think I'll change the name of my scary videos month to Spooky October. And I know my channel isn't about lying about stuff, and I'm not lying, but I have been doing scary videos all month. I've just had other stuff in between them. Hell, I have the Yang character shorts for tomorrow, and that Injustice 2 video on React to. And the last Injustice 2 video had a lot of views. Alright, let's just, now that I've got that all cleared out so you guys know I'm not lying, let's do this. We are watching or listening to 4 disturbing true playground horror stories. Let's go. Suddenly just got chills from spawn. That swing. Number 1, Marvin S. Wade. Number 2, Craig. I can't speak French. Story 3, Savagery Inc. What's number 4? Okay. So, hopefully, no kids get hurt in this, or us. I mean, it's a playground. Of course, they're gonna get stalked. Little files. Bring it on. Story 1.
When I was 17.
Take it back. Sorry, we had some difficulties to attend to. So.
When I was 17, in my last year of high school, I was finally starting to hit things off with the girl I liked.
At a playground?
Her Lynn. Lynn was a big pot smoker. At the time, it really wasn't my thing, but.
Smoke weed every day. Snoop Dogg, I do not just.
I went along with it just because. I live a couple blocks from her, so I always walked before I got a car.
Mm-hmm.
Across the street from her house is a park. Commonly at night, she'd instant message me on AOL to come hang out at the park.
Oh, just one more thing. Buy this for your cats, because Ginger loves it. Let's get back. Sorry. Still not gonna be the last interruption I do.
Sometimes we'd just sit on the playground at night and talk for hours. Sometimes she'd convince me to smoke with her.
No.
It was always such a private place to hang out and talk, especially at night. A line of thick trees surrounded the playground as well, creating a wall of sorts.
Uh-huh.
Well, one night we both snuck out around 12 and met at the playground in the park. We talked for a while. Then Lynn perked up, playfully hit me on the shoulder, and said, we should play hide-and-seek. It may sound immature for a couple seniors in high school to play hide-and-seek.
Why are you doing that at a playground?
It just seemed like it would be fun. She told me to go to the trees and count to 30. When
30,
I was
I'm
done,
counting
my
10.
First instinct was, of course, to check the playground. And if she wasn't there, I'd move on to the picnic bench area.
Oh, you weren't at the playground.
We always had
okay.
Flashlights on us when we went to the park.
Yeah.
Because this was before everyone had phones with flashlights in their pockets. I stepped from the grass onto the wood fiber mulch.
So what, is this the 1980s or 1990s?
Surrounding the playground.
I'm saying, where did this take place?
I hid my flashlight up to the playground, because I guess I was too lazy to go up there if I didn't have to. You know those big plastic circular things with a bunch of tiny holes in it that a lot of playgrounds have? Maybe not, but there was one of those things up at the highest level of the playground. And through a bunch of holes, I could see what appeared to be skin and a jacket, but what stood out the most was her eye peering through one of the holes. Instead of going up there right
That's
away,
not her.
I decided it would be fun to kind of mess with her. I waved the flashlight around the playground, pretending like I didn't see her.
Idiot.
I was gonna walk to the picnic area, turn on the flashlight, walk around to the trees, back to the playground, sneak up on her, and scare the living daylight out of her. Don't ask me why, I just wanted to.
That would be a good idea.
I walked
to
the picnic area, shut off the flashlight, and snuck back over to the playground. I was careful not to make noise as I crept through the wood chips that the playground sat on. Before I could even step foot on the first platform of the playground, something grabbed my arm and pulled me.
Nope.
I actually screamed, but stopped when I heard Lynn's laughter. I turned on the flashlight and was relieved to see it was her. The prank obviously backfired completely. After that, we went back up to the second level platform of the playground that we always chilled in. I asked her if she knew that I saw her behind that plastic thing at the top of the playground, but she was confused. She acted as if she never went up there.
Because she wasn't.
I explained to her that I saw someone up there. We both looked up as the tiny creaking sounds we had been hearing every so often suddenly made a disturbing amount of sense. I aimed the light up there, which revealed someone's head hunched over the railing of the...
Nope. I'm getting up. Nope. I've, at a park, seen someone doing this. No. No, I'm not. And about that life, I'm leaving. I'm never going back to that. And we can go in the daytime with our future kids. We are not going here at nighttime. Come on, some of you agree with me, right? You're just not going to sit there and watch as a person creeps over the head and just goes like this. Like the freaking Pennywise dancing clown. Just not in the sewer. No, I'm leaving. I'll leave you too if you had to.
Platform above us. At the same time, we heard footsteps kicking the wood chips around right below the platform we were sitting on.
No.
I made the first move for us to run, and Lynn followed suit. I turned out my flashlight while we ran, which wasn't long since Lynn's house was right across the street. We went to her room, shut the curtains, and I stayed there for the night, not wanting to go home. That marked the end of our late night visits to the park.
Should it be a last night visit? Story 2.
Do you have any memories from when you were a little kid that just make you uncomfortable to think about? Especially since you were so young at the time that you didn't know any better? Well, this is my...
Pretty sure my mom has a few of those things. I remember when I was small, I grabbed an egg and I threw it either to the top of the roof in my dad's kitchen. And, it was hilarious.
Fine. My mom used to take me to this really big playground in my town. When I say really big, I'm not exaggerating. It was probably the biggest playground you'd ever
Is
seen.
Is that it?
If only I knew the name of it. The playground was entirely wooden, and every Saturday and Sunday there would be at least 50 kids playing across it, with the parents all tucked away in the shaded area, reading their magazines and whatnot. One typical busy day at the playground, I was running along a big open platform when an older woman stopped me and said hi. She kept going on and on about how cute I was, and how she loved my blonde hair. It started to seem like she knew me based off the way she was talking to me.
Sorry.
And she told me that my mom left, that she told her to take me home.
What?
Keep in mind...
No! Don't just get a random person. Hi, old lady. Can you please take my son home? Even though you don't know my address home. Please. What? Why did you leave in the first place?
And I was only 6, so I believed her. The woman took me to the parking lot, to an old station wagon, where a man, I now presume to be her husband, was sitting in the driver's seat. He acted all friendly to me as the woman motioned me into the back seat, but I remember him yelling and lecturing at her about something.
Mm-hmm.
The man drove very aggressively and quickly as he was leaving the parking lot. We came to the light at the park. It was red. Just then, a car pulled up behind us and laid on the horn. I looked behind us, and it was my mom's car. The man blew through the red light, which even I picked up on, and started flooring it down the streets.
watch your kids. Please. Just at least eagle eye them. She's like, if I saw some random lady go, I miss. Yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna. Nope. Come on, we're going home.
I started to cry and scream as I realized my mom didn't know these people. Not long after, the man pulled the car over and yelled at the top of his lungs at me to get out of the car.
Yep, get out, go.
I opened the door, still crying my eyes out in fear. My mom pulled up next to me, ran out of the car, and hugged me. In the heat of the moment, she didn't get the tag number.
When?
Nor was she able to call the police, since this was 2001. There were no cell phones.
I wasn't even born then.
I wish I didn't remember this day so clearly. I would have rather it just been one of those memories that the brain chooses to repress.
Brain chooses, and sometimes it hates you. Number three, just watch your kids, please. You don't need problems.
I'm a single father, Kurt.
Like Mom, what would you do if you saw a random woman talking to me? If I was
grab you and tell her to leave my child alone.
Can you say it louder? I don't know if you heard that, but that's my mom.
I'm too paranoid for anything to happen like that.
And that concludes the Hood's mom's cameo. Let's go.
I'm living with my 5-year-old son. I have an old wooden playground in my backyard. It has a tire swing, monkey bars, and a big slide.
Sounds awesome.
A couple times recently, I've heard noises coming from the playground at night. I'll start from the first night. I woke up one night last week to the sound of something squeaking from outside. I recognized it to be the sound of the rusty chain of the tire swing spinning around. I also heard a young child's laughter out there.
Just so you like to let you know, I never had a normal childhood. I just have a grumpy uncle and weird mom. And that concludes my story.
I thought it was my son, so I went to his room to find him in his bed, fast asleep. My heart dropped as I saw him in his bed.
There are kids who break into your apartment.
Well, when I opened the back door to the backyard, there was no one back there.
Ghosts.
The tire swing was spinning slowly, however, as if somebody had just gotten off of it.
Ghosts.
I chalked it up to some kid just sneaking into my yard and went back to sleep.
Ghosts.
The next night, however, I woke. Woke up again to the sound of someone stomping up and down the slide, once again accompanied by the sound of a child's laughter.
Ghosts.
I checked my son's room once again to find him in bed. This time I thought I'd be a little smarter about it and check the window first before going outside. Nothing was out there, though. Not on the playground, at least.
First thing that came...
I still went outside anyway, just to make sure.
First thing that popped into my mind if I saw it for the second time.
For a couple nights, nothing happened, and I completely forgot about it. But on the third night, while in bed, a knock at my window startled me.
Oh.
I sat up in shock for a good minute, afraid to look outside.
I was gonna go.
Eventually, I was brave enough to do so. I looked out the foggy window. Through the smudge, I could see both the swings on the swing set swinging lightly, accompanied with the laughter of a child again. I ran as fast as I could down those stairs and out the back door, but instead of finding a couple of deviant little kids back there, instead I saw some towering figure looming at the top of my playground, surely looking at me. My courage turned to pure cowardice as I turned to run back inside, lock the door, and dial 911. The wait for an officer to arrive was the longest 20 minutes I'd ever experienced. By the time they got there, though, the figure on the playground was gone. They took down what little information I could give them and left. I wish I could say that was the last occurrence, but just last night, there was another knock at my window. I simply ignored it this time, though. I'm dreading going to sleep tonight. I think I'm going to install security cameras on my house soon. Either way, I'll give an update on what happens.
Man, you need to put electric fence all over your walls. me if I saw, can you just imagine that? Just someone going, man, you remember that stick that I showed you? That one video I did? Hi, whack! Now get the hell out of my property. Hmm? What do you think? Good? Now let's just carry on the story. We have one left. One left! I gotta shut up all the time, right? Yeah. Story 4.
I was 13 years old. My bedroom window faced the playground outside. It was a hot spring night with a light rain, so I had the window open, allowing me to hear the raindrops, as well as a strange squeaking sound. It really started to get annoying, so I went to the window to see what it could be. There was someone sitting on the swing set. I nearly screamed, but covered my mouth instead. What was really scary is that the swing was in the direct line of sight from my window, and the person on the swing was staring straight at my window. I could only hope they didn't see me. I was too scared to go across the house to my parents' room. Instead, all I really wanted to do was hide in my bed and hope they would go away. But the squeaking went on and on.
Nope, just stay.
I covered my ears not only because I was scared, but also because of the annoyance of the sound.
Put some earbuds, play some music, you'll be good.
Gigi! Finally, at last, the squeaking stopped. I gave it a few seconds before I quietly got out from bed and went back to the window. This time, I actually screamed. The person who was previously on the swing.
I came out of nowhere. Thing scared me because it came out of nowhere!
Now standing at most 10 feet from my window.
No.
Looking in. Close enough for me to make out his horrid face, with his eyes locked onto mine. But only for maybe a second or two, because I...
Oh crap, what did I do? What did I do then?
Screaming for my dad the whole way. My dad looked out the window, then went outside. He came back in 5 minutes later and said there were boot marks under the swings where a patch of blood accumulated, but he couldn't find the person who made them. This was 100% the scariest moment of my life.
If you don't know what I was doing there? Really? If you don't know what I was doing, that means barricade your windows. Okay, this video was brought... Five times garbage men found horrifying things in trash. Man, we gotta do this this tomorrow. 20 scariest and most ironic creepy pastas. We gotta do that tomorrow. This video is from Mr. Nightmare. He does a lot of these. I've watched a couple of them, so even if you ask me to them, I'm gonna search for them, and if it's the same one I've seen, you can thank Gator Martin for that. Go subscribe to Mr. Nightmare and Gator Martin, and because that's where I get these from. Bowsers. Alright, so that concludes today's video. Like, comment, share, and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Wham! Bam! Champ!